Hi Taurus, and welcome to your monthly tarot reading for May.
Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you are well and that you are having a good start to the week. And I'm using the Druidcraft Tarot. It's an impressive deck. I highly encourage you to check it out for yourself. And we can get a sense of the messages and energies or vibrations for Tuesday. And let's see if I can fit these large cards into frame here. Okay. Just about. So we have the Five of Cups, we have the Six of Swords, and we have the Three of Cups. And when we look at this Five of Cups illustration, we see this hooded figure sitting and looking at the water. And to his side are the three spilled cups. Behind him are two cups which are full. Often, this is a card that is about regret or thinking about lost opportunities or past events that have ended, and that you're feeling a sense of loss, you're feeling sadness, perhaps a little bit depressed, but this is a card where you're kind of thinking about what has spilled out of your life. And you know, the sadness may come because you can't recapture what has spilled. You know, you can't go back to time and to recreate that exact moment back in time. And so, you know, sometimes that leads to just a sense of sadness or loss or regret. Now, many folks and many tarot books say, well, this is, you know, you're focusing on what spilled, when really you should be thankful and be mindful of the abundance that you still have. You still have cups left. And that you can change your mindset and change your how you perceive things. And yes, that is absolutely true. You can certainly do that and look at the cups and instead of focusing, turn around and try to change your perspective. That's certainly one idea. The other idea is that sometimes it's okay to have a day of where you just need to cry it out. It's okay to mourn, to be mournful, or to acknowledge the sadness of the loss of a loved one, the loss of something important to you, perhaps the loss of a way of life that you had. So there are times when maybe it's okay and acceptable to grieve. And you know, we're so busy in society, it's like no time for that, move on, put on your happy face, that this card to me speaks through that it's, you know, it's okay to have those somber days and to just be wistful or to think about it. The problem is staying there and not moving forward. If you're never getting out of this situation of feeling regret or feeling loss, then that's not going to help you. But you know, this is a minor arcana. If you have a day or two where you're sluggish and you're like bummed out or whatever, just, you know, have some ice cream, have some coffee, and allow yourself to acknowledge those feelings, and then put it aside, and then you can move on. It's one approach of dealing with the Five of Cups. Now, related to the Six of Swords, this is a case of regret, perhaps, of lost opportunity, of sadness, relationship ends. Six of Swords is the, I've thought about this situation for quite a bit, and I've made my determination that I'm out, that I need to go find a better situation for myself. in the traditional Rider-Waite, you can see the calm water and then the rough little choppy water. And you don't see the faces in this illustration. You see the man and the woman, and you see the swords, and you see the person behind here, the oarsman, who was helping them move on. So this could be a card of cutting your losses in a place, that if you were having a hard time finding employment or finding a relationship in a certain town and you said, I'm out of here, I'm going to go to a bigger city or do something different, I'm going to change up my game so I can meet someone. You know, this is what the Six of Swords is about. So it's about really just saying, I'm ready for a new beginning, perhaps. I'm ready for exploration. I'm at a very literal level. This could indicate travel and that you're going somewhere. But often I think in tandem with this Five of Cups that it suggests that this was disheartening. And from disheartenment, you're deciding I'm going to make some changes and I'm going to move along. I'm going to go find those calm waters. And then we have the Three of Cups, which is a card that is about joy and friendship and celebrating and being with those closest to you. And so there's something to look forward to within this. But as I look at this, if I was reading a love reading, you know, I might say, gee, this might be related to a third party that caused some hurt and some sadness and some moving on. But in whatever context applies to you, Three of Cups is about being with your friends, and perhaps even if this is not related to a third party, is moving into a new place and having this sense of loss. You know, maybe you can spend some time with people that know you well and care for you and are there for you whenever you need them. That'll help to restore your spirit. It'll make you feel happy, because this is really a card of happiness and of celebration and of toasting the good things in life. And maybe you're toasting what's going to come that's going to be good for you and good to you. So, interesting reading for Tuesday, and let's take a look at the numbers. The numbers are 5, and 6 is 11, and 11 and 3 is 14, and 14 reduces to 1 plus 4 equals 5, and a 5 is about new cycles and adjustments or adaptation and some challenges and perhaps leading into freedom. So I hope that you found this reading helpful or something resonated with you today. If you enjoyed it, please like, share, or comment. And if you're new to the channel, it would be awesome if you thought about subscribing. And I really do appreciate all subscribers. I really do. So I hope you will check back again tomorrow for another reading. Take care. Bye-bye.